Hello everyone, hope you are doing well. So till now we have studied about test and measurement, and in today's lecture we are going to see about the topic evaluation. So this is the third part of any test and measurement. So what is evaluation? So process of making value judgments over a level of performance or achievement. This is known as evaluation, and it is based on qualitative data. And let's suppose that we are having any examination, and there are 50 number of students, and all of them are writing the same answer, answering the same question, and on the basis of their performance and the quality of their answers, we evaluate their copies. So it could be that all the students will get different marks according to their answers. So this is the process of evaluation. So what are the concept of evaluation? Let's see this quote, that evaluation is the collection, analysis and interpretation of information about any aspect of a program of education as part of a recognized process of judging its effectiveness, its efficiency and any other outcomes it may have. So it is a collection, or we can say that analysis of information about the programmatic education aspect, which is being recognized, or we can say that which is used with the help of judging, and it according to their effectiveness, efficiency and any other outcomes. So what are the natures of evaluation? Evaluation is a science of providing information for decision making. It includes measurement, assessment and testing. So it is a process that involves and information gathering, information processing, judgment forming, decision making. So these are the four things: information gathering, information processing, judgment forming and decision making, which comprises of evaluation. So what are the needs of evaluation? The first one is, it measures the effectiveness of the instructor, and it measures the effectiveness of impact in meeting objectives. So we can say that before evaluating anything, first of all, the effectiveness of the objective of the answer and the effectiveness of the instructor, that the both things should be measured very wisely. The third one is, it provides feedback to students and it provides student gratification and motivation. So these are the needs of evaluation. What are the characteristics of a good evaluation? The first one is validity. It should be valid. Reliability, practicability, fairness, usefulness and interpretation of results. So these are the characteristics which one must have before evaluating any of the problem. So let's see one by one. The validity. So actually test, what is sets out to test. So example of this validity is, questions that are intended to test recall of factual material, but which actually test the candidate's power of reasoning. So this can be stated as the things that is the answer, or is the answer given by the researcher or any student is valid or not. The second one is reliability. So it is a measure of the consistency with which the question, test or examination produces the same result under different but comparable conditions. So one evaluative question should test only one thing at a time. So this must be reliable and adequately reflect the objectives of the teaching unit. And next one is practicability. So it should be realistic, practical and efficient in terms of their cost, time taken and case of application. So this must be kept in mind before doing any research, that our evaluation process must be cost effective and must take very less time. Next one is fairness. So it reflects the accurate ranger of expected behaviors as desired by the course objectives, and information provided to the students about the evaluation, such as nature of the material, the form of structure of examination, length of the examination and values. These values must be in terms of any marks. This must be provided to the students before any evaluation. usefulness. So useful for students knowing their strength and weakness, and it suggests all the needful requirements for the student improvement. So let's move on to the next topic, that is the interpretation of result. So first of all, what we have done, we have studied test, after that measurement, after that we have evaluated the things which we got from the measurement, and at the last, what we are doing, we are interpreting doing interpretation of the results. So it is a test score, or we can say that a test score is meaningful if the teacher or counselor is able to decide what significance or importance should be attached to it and to make some judgment concerning its relationship to other kind of information about the student. So from the result, what we interpret, that what are the inputs or what are the add-ons which we will give to the student or any researcher, so that his answer or his findings must be very much significant. So there are three types of evaluation. The first one is formative evaluation, the second one is summative evaluation, third one is continuous and comprehensive evaluation. So let's start with all the three types of evaluations. The first one is formative evaluation. So it monitors student learning to provide ongoing feedback that can be used by instructors to improve their teaching and by students to improve their teaching, by students to improve their learning. So with the help of teaching and learning process, this formative evaluation must be monitored, and it helps students identify their strength and weakness and target areas that need work. So the weakness and the strength of any student or researchers must be identified before any assessment. So it helps faculty recognize where students are struggling and address problem immediately. So this is the very much very important, or we can say very useful point of this formative evaluation, that the part or the things where a student is struggling or a researcher is struggling must be recognized by any faculty or the guide. So it is of a low stake. For example, ask the students to, the first one is draw a concept map in class to represent their understanding of a topic. The second one is submit one or two sentences to identify the main points of a lecture. And the third one is turn in a research proposal for early feedback. So while having these three questions, or we can say that these three tasks, we can say that what are the formative evaluations. The second one is summative evaluation. So evaluate student learning at the end of an instructional unit by comparing it against some standard or benchmark. So in this summative evaluation, what we do, that we have some level or we have some cutoff, and we decide the answer of the student with the according to that cutoff. So it is a high stake, that means that it have a high point value, such as midterm exam, final project, paper, senior recite. So these are the things which comes under the summative evaluation. So let's see what are the use of evaluations. So it is used to formulate the objectives, designing of learning experience, and assessment of learner performance. So it is useful to bring improvement in teaching and learning curriculum, and it provides accountability to the society, parents, and to the education system. So with the help of this education, we can also provide accountability to the parents and the education system. So we will start evaluation approach in the next lecture. Thank you.